Hey everyone, today we're going to go through the process of creating a kill block in Roblox Studio. And to begin with, of course, open your Roblox Studio or whatever project you're working on. And then the next step is to add a part which we want to be the kill block. So I'm just going to click on part really quick in the model section. And there's our part that I want to use, except I am going to make mine a little bit bigger. There we go. And now when this part is selected, we're going to go over to the Explorer on the right side. There's a little plus icon. Let's click on that. And then we're going to move down and we're going to add a new script by just clicking on it. And it should bring us right here to our new script that we just created. And the first thing we can do is delete this line that Roblox adds for us. We don't need that. And then we're going to need to create a new variable for that block, which we added to the world. In order to get the block in the script, we have to type local kill block is what I'm going to call it equals script.parent. So this will only work if the script is attached to the block. And see, as you can see in the Explorer, the script is attached to the block and the block is the script's parent. That's why when we do script.parent, we are grabbing the part in the Explorer. And then we need to create a function that will run every time something touches the block. So we're going to call this local function on touch, let's call it. And inside the parentheses, we're going to add other part. And then after that line, we're going to hit enter. Now we create a function, except now we have to make our function do something. So the first part is to check if the other part, which is whatever touched our block, is a model. We're going to call this local model equals other part colon find first ancestor, which is a parentheses. And inside the parentheses, we're going to add quotation marks and the word model inside the quotation marks. And then we have to put if model then. And so what we just wrote, what this is doing, it is checking to see if one of the parents, if what touched the block is a model. And if it is a model, so if model then, what we're going to have to do is check to see if that's a human that touched that block. Because another model could have touched the block, but we only care if it's a human. So now we have to check if it's human. So we have to add another variable, a local. Every variable, every function starts with local. And then we're going to call this human equals, and then model, which is what we called our model, colon. We're going to call a function on the model. And this one's going to be first. Find first child, which is a parentheses, quotation marks, humanoid. And then we're going to hit enter. So now, if human, then, so first, we check to make sure the part that touched the block is a model. And if it's a model, now we have to check if it's human. And if it's human, now all we have to do is set its health to 0 to kill it. That health equals 0. And there we go. And now we have to do one last step in order to actually connect the block to the function we just created. So after all of this, after the last end for the function, we're going to create a couple new lines. And we're going to write kill block, the variable we named, which is our part that when the player touches, they will die, dot touched. So when the player touches the block, we're going to connect the function we just made called onTouch. And you can remove this parentheses and the line should just look like this. And this is our whole entire function, which I will also post down below. So now let me hit play. And once my character spawns in, we should see that when we hit the block, we will die. And there's the block. And there we go. We're dead. And that is how you create a kill block in Roblox. And now one step that I always like to do is just to let the player know that this block is going to kill them when they touch it. You should probably set the brick color to red. So make sure your part's selected, and then the properties panel on the right, there's a brick color option under appearance. We're gonna click on that and set that to red. Now players will know that this block will kill them if they touch it. And congratulations, you just made a kill block in Roblox. See you next time.